Hey there, I'm Benjamin from Loves Data. Welcome to the seventh lesson in my Google Tag Manager training series. In this final lesson, we'll cover extra tips for using Google Tag Manager and resources you can use to learn even more about tag management. And if you're new to the series, then please check out the other lessons. You can find links to all of the lessons in the description below this video. Okay, now it's time to get started. Let's begin with extra tips for using Google Tag Manager. My first tip is that you can use Google Tag Manager to add other elements to your website, not just tags. For example, you can use Google Tag Manager to add social sharing widgets to your blog or add a chat widget to your product pages. Let's take a look. I've created an account for a chat widget I want to add to my website. And here we can see the code we need to embed on our website to add the widget. Let's copy the code. And now let's head to Google Tag Manager. Now I can create a new tag. Name the tag. And then select Tag Configuration. Now I can choose custom HTML as the tag type. And I can paste the code for my chat widget into the configuration for the tag. Now let's add a trigger to the tag. We could choose the All Pages trigger to add the widget to all of the pages on our website. Or we can click the plus sign to create a new trigger. Let's say we just want to add the widget to our contact page. We can name our trigger Contact Page. And then select Page View as the trigger type. We can then choose Some Page Views and select Page Path, then Contains, and enter /contact-us. This means that our widget will only be added to pages with /contact-us in the URL on our website. You can then save the trigger and the tag. Let's preview our changes. We can now see the chat widget added to our website. The next tip is that you can use a browser extension to inject the Google Tag Manager code on any website. This is particularly useful if you want to test your tags and implementation before the code is added. Let's take a look. This demo site doesn't have Google Tag Manager installed yet, which means we can't test or preview the tags we've created. So I've installed the Scriptly extension for Chrome, which lets us inject extra code. Let's open the extension and add a new script. We can name the script paste our Google Tag Manager container code and remove the opening and closing script tags. We can also create a rule for when we want the script to run, so we can select Host and enter the domain of our website. We can then select the option to automatically inject the script. Now let's head to Google Tag Manager and let's preview our container. We can now select the Tag Assistant tab, and we can see that Google Tag Manager has been loaded on my demo site using the Chrome browser extension. This means we can test our implementation without needing to have the container code added to the live website. Then when we're ready, we can add the container to our website instead of just using the browser extension. This is a great tip if you're helping someone else get up and running with Google Tag Manager. And if you're not sure how to add the container to your live website when you're ready, then I've included a link to the previous lesson where we covered implementation in the description below this video. My next tip is that you can export and import containers in Google Tag Manager. This lets you copy existing implementations you've configured and also lets you get started quickly. Let's head back to Google Tag Manager to take a look. To export or import a container, select Admin. And then you can see the option on the right. Let's choose Export. You can then choose if you want to export the current version of the container at the top or one of the other versions of your container. Then you just need to click Export and you'll download a file that you can share with others to import the configuration of your container. Let's close this. And let's select Import. If you've already downloaded an exported container, then you can use this option to import it into another Google Tag Manager container. If you'd like to download a copy of the exported container we've configured during this training series, then you can find a link in the description below this video. Okay, now that we've covered extra tips, I want to share extra resources you can use to continue learning even more about Google Tag Manager. First up is the Google Tag Manager Help Center. The Help Center has articles covering important concepts through to guides to help you set up different types of tags. It also includes the Google Tag Manager release notes that let you view the most recent changes that the Google Tag Manager team have made to the product. In the Help Center, you can also select the Community tab. This is a great place to ask questions about Google Tag Manager and search through all the other questions people have asked. And I also recommend checking out the Tag Manager section in Google Developers. It provides technical articles covering implementation and customization options, including details about the data layer and how to implement e-commerce tracking. Google also has a Google Tag Manager Fundamentals course in their Analytics Academy. The course covers getting started, setup, important concepts, and tag configuration, so it's worth checking out. And apart from Google's resources, I also recommend checking out the learning resources I've put together. They include articles, PDF guides, and my other videos. I've included links to my resources in the description below this video. And if you're looking to learn Google Tag Manager by following a structured curriculum, then take a moment to check out my Google Tag Manager course. In the course, you'll learn even more best practice techniques for setting up and managing your tags using this powerful tool. So they're my extra tips for Google Tag Manager and how you can learn even more about managing your tags. Remember, you can use Google Tag Manager to add any additional tags you like to your website, like when you need to add that chat widget. It's not just about adding analytics tags. I also suggest reviewing the tags you've configured in Google Tag Manager at least every 6 to 12 months. You might find there are tags that you no longer need, so this is a great way to keep things neat and tidy in your container. And don't forget, you can find links to a whole bunch of extra resources in the description below this video. That's all for now. See you next time.